The following opinions are solely those of BoatTEST.com and its test captain.
Hi, Captain Steve for BoatTEST.com, and in this video, we conduct a performance evaluation and features inspection of the Vexus AVX1880, an aluminum bass boat powered by Evinrude's new 3-cylinder E-TEC G2 115 horsepower high output engine. Let's take a look and see how this matchup works out. Since speed is essential for bass boats, let's start with the performance. The AVX1880 measures 18 feet 10 inches long with a 7 foot 11 inch beam. Empty weight is listed at 1,500 pounds. With two people, 24 gallons of fuel and test equipment on board, we had an estimated test weight of 2,479 pounds. Our test boat was powered by a 3-cylinder Evinrude G2 115HO outboard turning a 14.5 by 21 inch RX3 stainless steel propeller. The prop is one of the new wheels designed explicitly for this new series of engines. Cranking up the engine to 5750 RPM at wide open throttle, we hit a top speed of 50 miles per hour. Best cruise came in at 3000 RPM, where we recorded 26 miles per hour and a fuel burn of 3.3 gallons per hour. That translated to 7.9 miles per gallon and a range of 227 statute miles, while still holding back a 10% reserve of the boat's 32-gallon total fuel capacity. It's noteworthy that the boat got onto plane at 3000 RPM, which is relatively low for a boat of this type. In acceleration tests, the AVX 1880 SE planed in 3.4 seconds and ran through 20 miles per hour in 5.6 seconds. Vexus designs the AVX 1880 with a center pad running surface and 6 lifting strakes. When the boat's trimmed for optimum performance, it rides on the pad, which improves the overall performance and efficiency. To ensure that the AVX 1880 can handle less than ideal conditions, she's built with a vector force transom and series of longitudinal and traverse supports to provide a strong, stable hull. The boat is all aluminum, without any wood, and all seams and structures are welded together before flotation foam is injected into empty voids. The boat will float level if swamped. Now let's take a closer look at the 3-cylinder Evinrude E-TEC G2 115HO 1.9-liter 2-stroke outboard. One of the most important attributes of the new 115-horsepower high-output motor is its torque. That's because the 2-stroke makes power on every stroke of the crankshaft. The key to the Evinrude's performance is the engine's direct in-the-cylinder fuel injection. Only Evinrude engines have this feature in class. At lower RPM, the injection system uses stratified combustion to deliver a minimum amount of fuel to the smaller upper part of the cylinder, which gives the engine its excellent fuel economy. In addition to delivering superior torque, the engine is CARB 3 star certified and has the lowest emissions in class. Evinrude claims the new series of engines are the most fuel-efficient in class. The hydraulic power steering pump is integrated into the engine's midsection's mounting bracket. This facilitates installation and rigging. The E-TEC G2 115HO is equipped with Evinrude's auto trim function, which automatically trims the engine. This helps with handling and to get the boat on plane. Now let's check out the AVX 1880's features starting at the bow. The forward casting deck is 7 feet 6 inches long and 6 feet 2 inches wide, tapering to 4 feet 2 inches wide forward. According to Vexus, its stretched form gunnels provide maximum space for fighting fish. The test boat had the Minn Kota 4-Trax trolling motor with a recessed foot pedal well, a tool rack, and cup holder. Forward of the removable seats are the optional Humminbird Helix 7 fish finder, and to starboard are the motor trim and nav anchor light switches. Retractable buckle straps secure the rods quickly when it's time to change fishing spots. Outboard on each side are fold-up cleats to ensure that fishing lines don't get snagged when the bite is on. Bow storage includes lockable compartments flanking the center rod locker that has dedicated tubes for 10 rods. The hatches are all reinforced with longitudinal braces so they don't sag when someone walks on them. It's a 7-inch step down from the bow to the single step and another 8-inch step down to the cockpit. There's storage beneath the hinged top. The cockpit on our test boat had an optional center seat between the bucket seats for 3 across seating. Outboard of the port guest seat is another strap for quickly securing rods. The helm console has analog-style gauges on each side of the Humminbird Helix 7 fish finder. The helm console could hold up to 12-inch screens for fishing data, but we would swap the positions for the fuel and trim gauges. Bass boats are trim sensitive and the trim gauge would be easier to see to starboard. Outboard to starboard are the accessory and live well switches. The shift throttle control is comfortably positioned. The helm console is solidly built and color coordinated to the boat. To facilitate getting to the aft fishing deck, the optional center cockpit seat folds down to form a non-skid step. The aft fishing area measures 7 foot 1 inch wide and 3 feet 10 inches fore and aft. The port side of the transom has a fold-down reboarding ladder. Across the front of the aft deck are twin lockers on each side of the centrally positioned live well. There are dividers for the live well, which is aerated. The large hatch in the center of the aft deck opens to provide access to the batteries, charging system, and built-in live well pumps. That's my full features and inspection performance evaluation of the Vexus 1880. With the new Evinrude G2 115HO providing the power, the Vexus AVX1880 is a smooth-running, efficient, fast boat that's built with some interesting technology, and it's a pleasure to drive. For BoatTEST.com, I'm Captain Steve. We'll see you on the water.